The pandemic has hit communities hard in many different ways, and a new survey shows it's also taken a toll on museums, some not sure whether they'll be able to keep their doors open.
News 3 reporter Zach Zollheimer breaks down the information and spoke to one Virginia Beach museum about how they're surviving the pandemic.
Virginia Boca is here to stay.
At the Virginia Museum of Contemporary Art,
this line here is actually sand.
You'd find all sorts of displays.
This is a Chihuly chandelier. This room was built in 2005 specifically for this piece of artwork.
The museum reopening in July after being closed roughly 5 months during the pandemic.
We've had just around 3,000 people come through the museum over the last 3 months. Our museum is in a good spot relative to where it could be.
Brad Tuggle says the museum had concerns at first.
There were a lot of furloughs with the museum. We went down to about 40% of our staff. We didn't know if this pandemic was going to shut us down for 3 months or 3 years.
Anecdotally, we knew that museums were significantly impacted by the pandemic the second they had to close their doors.
The American Alliance of Museums surveyed museums to get a feel for impacts from the pandemic. At least 750 museum directors responded to the survey in June. One-third of respondents were not confident they would be able to survive 16 months without additional financial relief, and 16% felt their organization was at significant risk of permanent closure. During the pandemic, 75% of museums stepped into roles as educators, providing virtual education programs and experiences. Two-thirds of directors predicted cuts in education, programming, and other public services due to significant budget cuts.
It is really unfortunate, and the number isn't surprising because museums do have to cut where they can in order to survive the impact of the pandemic.
We had a lot of people on staff and in the community that in that first month really stepped up.
Tuggle says funding from the city and other partners, as well as launching a virtual museum, helped a lot.
It really gave us an avenue to get that artwork out to the world, which is what we're here for.
As they continue on, Kashan hopes many will support other museums around the country during this time.
Their communities are going to need their museums more than ever to help sustain their economies and their educational systems and to provide respite and healing as we look to the recovery in the future.
In Virginia Beach, Zach Dahlheimer, News 3.